In this video, we look at how to find the lowest common multiple of a set of numbers. This is exactly the opposite concept to what we saw in the last video, which was greatest common factor. So lowest common multiple, commonly called LCM, very different from greatest common factor. Please try not to confuse those two. It's a very common mistake. So if we're trying to find a multiple of a set of numbers, what that means is it has to be at least as big as the largest one. So if I'm trying to find the lowest common multiple here of 6 and 9, the number that I'm going to end up with, my answer has to be bigger than 9. 6 and 9, small numbers, we can probably just do this in our head with a list. Multiples of 6 are 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, etc., etc. And multiples of 9 are 9, 18, 27, 36, etc., etc., etc. Now that we've got the list of multiples of these numbers, all we do is find which is the number that is the first appears in all the lists that we're looking at. Here we've got just two, and the smallest number is 18 that appears in both. So 18 is the LCM of 6 and 9, the smallest number that both 6 and 9 will divide into. Let's try an example that's a little bit tougher. What is the lowest common multiple of 24 and 54? Well, we could list these off, it just would take a while, and we'd have to be crunching a lot of numbers on our calculator. So, we'll use prime factorization, that we saw a couple videos ago, to work out how to write 24 as a product of prime factors and 54 as a product of prime factors. That's our first step. So, set up the factor tree for 24. 24 is 4 times 6, 4 is 2 times 2, and 6 is 2 times 3. We've got prime numbers at the end of every branch, so we'll stop there. 24 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. And we'll do the same for 54. 54 is, would that be 6 times 9? 6 is 2 times 3, stop there. And 9 is 3 times 3, stop there. So 54 is 2 times 3 times 3 times 3. Now, we've got a prime factorization of the numbers that we're trying to find the lowest common multiple of. Here's how this works. We grab all of the numbers in one set. So we've got three twos and a three already. That says that the lowest common multiple has to be at least that big. Now, two is already a factor of our lowest common multiple that we're trying to find here, so I don't need to worry about that two in 54. And three is already a factor of our lowest common multiple, so I don't need to worry about that three. However, I do need these additional 3's down here. So, the lowest common multiple is going to be the product of all those numbers. 2 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 3. And for that number, you might have to grab a calculator. 2 cubed is 8, 3 cubed is 27, so that's going to be 8 times 27. Oy. And that's going to be 160 plus 56, so that's going to be 216. Is going to be the smallest number that both 24 and 54 will divide into. That's how to use prime factorization to find the lowest common multiple of a set of numbers.